are coming to you live from the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, an evening with Dr. Robert Duncan on TM Radio. This will be a Q&A presentation with contributions from the listeners. I ask that you refrain from your questions until I have indicated that I have completed my series. And that should be most of the first half. The second half will be devoted to listener Q&A. Now, you can call in and ask a question or comment at 800-313-9443. Call in and just listen at 605-313-0163. I have found it most difficult to write to include everything that Dr. Robert Duncan has accomplished in his lifetime. This feat would take the balance of the entire evening. I will begin with books that he has authored. The ones that I am familiar with are How to Tame a Demon, Project Soul Catcher, and The Matrix Deciphered. The first two are available on Amazon, and they are a very good read for a target. His education is exemplary. After preparatory school, Dr. Robert Duncan attended Harvard University. He graduated with high honors in computer science and a minor in pre-med. He then earned advanced degrees from Harvard and Dartmouth in business and science. He has, to his credit, an AB, MBA, SM, and PhD. Preceding graduate school, Dr. Duncan worked for the Department of Defense, Navy, NATO, and various intelligence agencies' computer science divisions. His research interests have been in neural networks, virtual reality, and EEG-controlled robotics. Dr. Duncan has been a professor, inventor, artist, and writer. He is one of the last Renaissance men. His lineage to include President Lincoln, King Duncan of Scotland, and William Bradford, the first governor of Massachusetts. Okay, I have question one. Dr. Duncan, where do you believe the source of the signals that inflict this torture upon the citizens of the United States is located, and in your opinion, or based in fact, are there many locations sending out these signals to ground-based radar or satellite platforms?
Okay, you you went right for the kill. Remember, I worked for DARPA on advanced sensors and systems. Wrote the artificial intelligence code, tracked all the submarines and ships on Earth, integrate them with the airspace defense systems as well. So I can't tell you specific locations, obviously, but what I can tell you is just using logic, we can track back mind control of citizens to the early 60s, and there were no satellites at the time. So that means this trick can be done without satellites. So obviously, we've integrated all the systems now. I've identified 26 ways of which to manipulate the human nervous system and the brain. I do agree with Dr. Nick Baggage that ionospheric heaters are an over-the-horizon radar are good sources to look for that kind of thing. Most people believe it's localized. It's their neighbor doing it through the wall to them. And perhaps in the beginning, maybe that's true, and I'm sure you'll ask me questions about stalking, but this is global. This is a global phenomenon. Unfortunately, there's nowhere on Earth you can escape, which means that it's using the full spectrum of electromagnetic energy and some very interesting physics that I can't quite get into, but when I die, I'm releasing some information. I think you nailed a few. From the ground, wavelengths can travel both through the ionosphere, bounce off of them, and the Earth ground. So that's one part of it. And then we are bathed in a natural magnetic field of Earth. And with those two things, you have a nuclear magnetic resonance machine for the entire Earth, as well as some other high energy physics surveillance techniques like electron spin resonance and other things. So did they integrate it with satellites? Well, of course we did. And did we integrate it with cell phone tracking and everything else? Yes, we did. So the system of surveillance just gets better and better. But it was not necessary at the very beginning to do neurological linking. And the way they did it is super creepy. But maybe I'll hold off on that and let you ask your next question.
Okay, you stepped on one of my next questions, but actually it's farther down. Dr. Duncan, do you believe that there is any kind of trickle-down theory of this technology leaking in effect from the government to the private sector and finally to the private citizen?
Oh, absolutely. Excellent question. So the strategy that we use, in the secret agencies, I see my own work from 25 years ago just now becoming new with the civilian sector scientists. And so what we do is we test it. We see all the warfare capabilities. We use it in secret. So it's confusing to whatever people were using it on. And the strategy is to suddenly show, wow, we can communicate with brains and we can cure all this mental illness, while in fact it was a weapon to create every type of mental illness, to discredit future politicians, or to eliminate whatever dissenters we wanted to. So, yes, that's exactly what's going on, is it's being leaked to the public sector. So it's a parallel reconstruction of what we already did, and then they can pass laws and regulations. But they don't want the public to know all the atrocities of menicide and genocide we've used these types of weapons for.
Okay, Dr. Duncan, do you have any information that might suggest that government installations have been hacked or access to these installations sold to private parties? Relative to this, could a DOD or Navy website be accessed by operators hacking into the site?
Well, I mean, that's all, you know, the cyber warfare goes on all the time, but this is actually called cybernetic warfare, when you're interfacing with biological creatures as well as computer systems. And my answer is an absolute no. And the reason for that, this is considered a weapon of mass destruction of both minds or of populations. We can incite wars. We can, we get our redacted intel by dream programming and extraction. There are 100 uses that we've been using it for, and so the government would never allow this technology to be used by some criminal organization outside of their control. It's like giving people nuclear weapons. You wouldn't allow it.
Okay. Dr. Duncan, what do you feel that ultimately the reason is for this torture of our own people? I would like to think that it is China or Russia, but all evidence seems to point directly to the United States. Although we had one attack that I can think of from the Russian Duga antenna ray powered by the Chernobyl nuclear plant in the Soviet Union, July 4th, 1976.
Okay, you touched on a whole lot of topics. The U.S. Embassy in Moscow in the 60s was attacked by microwaves, and rather than protecting the employees, DARPA scientists were sent in to study what the Russians were doing and what the long-term effects were. And a lot of them got cancers and other things. So they weren't really protecting it. And that then leads to this Cuban embassy attack, which is, again, neurological weapons, but improved and can cause heating of organs such as the brain and cause traumatic brain injury, which is, again, we get into detail more important in rewiring the brain and making them into robotic slaves, if you will. And then you touched on that the Russians were doing it over us. Yeah, absolute true. That's in a DIA report, Defense Intelligence Agency report. They were sending microwaves over the U.S., so we did it to them. But we've even got our own Navy doing it, to towns in Oregon and Nevada and some other places. Now, you got to remember, human experimentation on our own population has a very, very long list. And we don't, as American citizens, we have pride in our country. We don't want to believe that we would be betrayed in such a way. And so they give us options. It's aliens doing it. It's demons. It's the Chinese, it's the Russians. But unfortunately, the Department of Defense, our Department of Defense, has almost $1 trillion in black budget and warfare equipment every year. And they have never warned U.S. citizens about these weapons. Why do you think that is?
Well, you've got me there. Everyone, all of the countries, seem to want to put a lid on this. Nobody wants to let the cat out of the bag.
Yeah. Isn't that interesting? And so I read some, someone sent me some CIA documents, and it said that they were, we actually work with the Russians on the cooperative advancement of these technologies. China, you know, they're a little late to the game, but they're there. And think about it. So if you have a nuclear weapon, well, you want to show that off so people, you know, other countries' tax bases are scared. But something like this is completely invisible, where you can control the guys with their fingers on the nuclear buttons. That you want to keep secret. If you tell everyone, it loses its power. They would be able to notice that they're under some sort of influence. They call it psychic influence, but it's really a neurological link using a cognitive model of that individual.
Okay, I just wanted to mention, we have callers stacked up. I have two more questions, and then we will open the lines. We are only going to do one commercial on the half hour. So this is the question that you sort of stepped on, I think. Dr. Duncan, the Schumann resonance is the only signal that exists naturally around the world. Can you identify a way in which the Schumann resonance could be used against us?
Yes. Interesting question again. And I've been asked that before. But if you look throughout history, the Schumann resonance, what is it, 8.3, roughly around there, hertz. And that is what we creatures evolved under. And the human brain, when it is most normal and relaxed and concentrated, happens to fall within the Schumann resonance, and that would make sense. And so if you were to overpower that natural Schumann resonance by a slightly different frequency, you could make that entity, I mean, this doesn't just apply to humans, applies to all animals with the brain. You can make them agitated. You could make them sleepy. All sorts of emotions. And another interesting fact is the Schumann resonance has harmonics. And those harmonics over the last 15 years have increased dramatically. We have to assume due to electromagnetic pollution. And yes, it's going to affect every creature and every mind on Earth. Just doing that very simple thing, using a harp-type weapon, would alter the emotional states of entire populations.
Okay, I have one more question. I actually have another, but I would like to, if I have time, I will ask it. Dr. Duncan, the use of PLC, or power line communication, is becoming a known fact, although little is known about its potential as a proposed secondary means of carrying maybe just voice to skull, and not the attacks which could come from another source.
Brilliant.
And I envision the Lily Wave, which is very brain friendly.
Yes. So you can go back to Russian literature, I think in the 1930s, and they were using power lines for these types of population control and mood control. And even now I remember I didn't fully answer a question you asked previously. Satellites can be taken over. You can use other people's satellite dishes for your communications. And so in a sense, you can take them over. And similarly, with extremely long wavelength frequencies, the Earth's power lines can be used as an antenna to pick up and retransmit these frequencies within the brainwave wavelengths. So your question is quite brilliant, and yes, it is true.
Okay, I have one last question, and that will finish out the half hour. The Massachusetts Institute of Technology released a paper which appeared in Optics Letters, January the 19th, 2019. This paper described the use of lasers to project voices to an individual having no receiver. Could this be a device that is used in conjunction with ground-based radar installations and satellites?
Yes, but however, that was invented a long time ago. Like I said, parallel inventions are allowed to happen. I think I've identified four different what we call voice-to-skull, or the Army calls it that, methods of piping voices into people's heads, voice of God weapons. You know, this is all lay down your arms, and they can't plug their ears even, and you know, the auditory cortex is stimulated, vibration of the brain itself causes the inner ear to vibrate and create sound and voices. There are several techniques, but that laser one was cool, but it's, you know, we have ultrasonics, we have LIDAR, or LRAD, I mean. And, I mean, we have a lot of ways we can do this, but you said in conjunction. In fact, it is necessary for the work that I do, which is called neural encrypted communications between brains. Initially, while the brains are learning each other's language, they need something like that to stimulate the voice, the sounds, the understanding, while we map out their neural structures and their cognitive models. So it could be as simple as everyone's watching the same TV show. Well, we can use that. But this would be definitely another way to do it, isolate the victim. And then once the neural encrypted link is learned, you don't need to use that anymore. And so then it's low probability of detection, we call it.
Okay, Dr. Duncan, is it possible in the very beginning to pre-train the brain that they use parallels, like your information, excuse me, on disk, and parallel questions and answers back and forth to see if they actually hit on one?
Okay, now you're talking about interrogation tactics. Yeah, these are well written about in the CIA manuals. And often when they grab a target, they use confusion tactics. You know, we're a satanic cult and you know, we're using magic on you and that kind of stuff. But they'll use usually four different interrogators in the beginning, and they'll ask questions. And part of the war games that are being conducted now is how well do these people score getting information, walking them back through their timelines. One of my CIA buddies told me this, that they do it with terrorists physically, with newspapers misprinted on the dates and things like that. But the same techniques are being used by these guys in the neurological realm. And the answer to your question is yes. That's a very common technique. And then they'll try to use maybe sleep deprivation so you don't remember that you gave up information. And then they pretend they have more information about you than, you know, through some other source, which, you know, it is the government. So they have many sources such as internet and, you know, all your records. But and by doing it that way, they get to see their skills of how they can go all the way back to your childhood, get everything that could be used as blackmail against you and your friends and et cetera. Yeah, that's a very big topic, is the interrogation techniques.
Okay. Papa from Tennessee, you have a question. You have 3 minutes.
Yeah, I actually have two of them. Can you hear me? Am I live?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good deal. Yeah, I actually have two questions, and hopefully I catch you before the song comes on. Going back to, well, not going back, you were just now speaking about techniques, and PSYOPs is how I like to refer to it. I'm from San Diego originally, and San Diego back in the day was known for primary control of certain narcotics. And do these programs, I mean, you said earlier, you know, that the stalking question's coming, and that's going to be me because I'm still at street level, although experiencing some other things are starting to come on, or I'm just noticing them. But for me, this started out as a psychological operation because when I was 18, I was young and dumb, and I chose to live a recreational lifestyle. And I do mean recreational. I was kind of a weekend warrior, although I had bouts of longer downtime. And so it would come in with an extravagant amount of theater, psychological theater. And is that a technique that you're familiar with, Doc?
Wow. Okay, the music's coming on. That would take me about 3 minutes, Dan.
Okay.
Should I wait for after the commercial to...
Yeah, sure. Okay. Papa, hang on. And we have to go to commercial, folks. Thank you very much for listening. And thank you, Dr. Duncan.
You are tuned in to the Republic Broadcasting Network. Visit our website by going to republicbroadcasting.org.
Tired of being lied to by mass media? It's growing more and more apparent today that news is received less and less through standard media outlets. Even with a growing audience every day, RBN is beginning to direct more efforts into social media. Social media and the use of the internet is fast becoming the primary source of people for news, regardless of demographic. RBN has set out to provide some of the best news on the internet through republicbroadcasting.org and also has begun to use the tools to our advantage by way of social media. Republic Broadcasting is now operating a Facebook page to function as yet another avenue to have our collective voice reach new audiences across not only America, but across the globe as well. The Facebook page features not only news, but also an RBN player to listen to our broadcast. Get involved by visiting facebook.com/republicbroadcasting and liking our page and share it with your friends and family, because you can handle the truth.
Many people tell us about their experience with Extendivite. Just listen to what Glenn has to say.
Prior to taking it, I had diabetic neuropathy. The Extendivite reduced that significantly. Acid reflux was reduced. I had athlete's foot, very severe. Trimmed that down to about 75%. Dandruff, almost completely gone. I had occipital neuralgia at the base of my skull. I was having migraines, reduced by about 90%. Heart palpitations, my heart would kind of stall out. I would skip a beat. Very uncomfortable. And when walking from downstairs going to sleep, by the time I got to the bedroom, which is just one flight of stairs, my heart was pounding, coming out of my chest. My vision was blurry. This completely solved that problem. Great product. Thanks.
Tell us your story. Get Extendivite today. Call 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
So, you love talk radio? Then you'll love TalkStreamLive.com. TalkStream Live is always on, 24/7, with the best streaming talk shows. Find your favorite talkers and discover some new ones. It's free, readily available online or on mobile with any smartphone or tablet. Finding your favorite talk shows all in one place has gotten a whole lot easier. Just go to TalkStreamLive.com. Be sure to download the free apps from Google Play or the iTunes App Store.
TalkRight, the conservative app offered by TalkStream Live that caters exclusively to the conservative talk radio community. Here you'll see only talk shows and podcasts from the conservative right, all the big broadcast names and online digital shows in one place. TalkRight makes it easy to find all your favorite conservative talkers with all the upscale features you come to expect from TalkStream Live. Keep up with the fast-paced political world. Download TalkRight today from Google Play or the App Store.
Okay, folks, somehow I got muted. Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. In case you've just tuned in, my name is Frank Allen. Tonight, we have an evening with Dr. Robert Duncan on TM Radio. I have finished my series of questions, and we are now opened up to the listeners. And call 800-313-9443 to get into the queue. Okay, Papa, go ahead.
Okay, so the last question was about what T.I.'s experience as street theater sensitization of specific actions, and I'll give you examples of one woman, Cheryl Welsh. People cough and blow smoke at her, and she was hypersensitized to that. Or it could be a color of a car. There's a guy in a psych ward right now, Todd Giffen, who was sensitized to whistling. And so the street theater, I don't fully know what's going on. The Stasi's used it for intimidation practices. There was a book, I think it was called The Confessions of an NSA Economic Hitman, and he talked about how he had to stalk people and let them know the U.S. government was watching them. And the Russians obviously did that too. You know, I mean, every country does it. And so what is the stalking for? It has a few purposes. It heightens paranoia. And so if you tell your friends, some big organization stalking me, well, then they write you off and your testimony is now discredited. That's one aspect. The other is it actually, paranoia and stress alters the biochemistry of the brain in a way that makes it the neural linkage converge more quickly. But here's what I'm doing to put people's fears to rest. Is I've been working on a program for 9 months now, and it's free, and it will allow all TIs to take pictures of those they believe are stalking them. Now, if it really is U.S. agents doing it, or a crisscross, let's say, between one of our Five Eyes intelligence agencies, because the CIA is not supposed to do that, we will have their picture, and it goes through facial recognition, and, well, they're out of work or might be killed in any other country they work in. So it may put an end to it if that's the true case. Otherwise, let's say it just ends up being random people. Well, then the next hypothesis is perhaps everyone is mind-controlled or can be around that person. And then the third hypothesis is it's the paranoia being induced into the target, which recognizes these events as important. And so with my program, I hope to sort all that out.
Okay. Yeah, you kind of hit on a lot of things there. Yeah, facial recognition. I'm running LPR, license plate reader software.
Yeah. I'm doing license plate reader software as well. Yeah.
I've got 16 high dev or high security cameras around my house. I talked on Frank's show how they hacked into it. This is a system that is not online. I do the manual updates, and they still manage to get in because you got to download the upgrade anyway. From an internet source, they managed to get into that, and the owner of the company was saying, "Who rewrote my code?" And then eventually he went silent, and, you know. But I've got a few people. I had one other question for you, Doc, and then I guess a few people are having trouble getting on. Frank, Maryland's firing.
Yeah, there's a lot of people, Papa.
Yeah, so real quick, Doc, I barely knew about you until about 2 weeks ago when Frank gave me a heads up that this night was coming. And so I did what little research I could because I've got about a billion other things I'm dealing with in life. This isn't the only thing. This isn't the only kettle in the fire. But
yeah.
I take it that you're a whistleblower, and I'm going to throw the question out rather hard. And, you know, unlike Bob Lazar that came out and said, here's element 115 and here's the ship, and until they created that in a particle accelerator, and even today people have trouble believing him, although it's more credible now, but why did you not come forward with or come out with any kind of tangible evidence like, say, Edward Snowden did? He not only said, look, there's an alien spaceship, here's
the
proof.
You answered your own question. This is my country, and I'm not leaving it till it's fixed. And so you got to play the game just right and walk the line. If I had top secret documents, they would have already arrested me, broken in, destroyed my life. So I can tell people what the truth is. I can show them where to look and what Freedom of Information Act documents they need, but I'm not going to solitary confinement in some Leavenworth prison. Does that answer your question?
That's a good, honest answer, Doc. And that's a question that actually a few people had, so I just kind of threw it. They're like, who's going to ask it? I'm like, I'll ask it. I'm not afraid to ask an honest man an honest question. Last question is not for me. It's from Maryland. Maryland, who is a very huge regular on this show and usually is up here. She's having trouble getting on. Her question is to you, Doc. Why is it that 75%, rough estimate, of targeted individuals are women?
Yes, I get asked that a lot. And I have a couple hypotheses. One, I know a lot of men TIs, and they are too embarrassed to talk about it, or they suck it up, or whatever it is. And so it may actually be equal proportions, but you just don't get to hear from the men as much. The other hypothesis is women are more easily controlled by their emotions, which is important in these experiments because they have more neural emotional wiring in general, you know, speaking. I even know some real life CIA honeypots. For example, it depends on their program. What are they being programmed to do? Just die or go on a killing spree in a school to change gun laws? What is their purpose ultimately? And I wouldn't know that without interviewing them and if they had voice to skull.
Okay, Papa, we'd like to move on to Melissa Ryan from Oklahoma.
Hi, Dr. Duncan. Hi, Frank.
Hi.
Hi. So, Dr. Duncan, I have a question for you. First of all, why is it some people get V2K and some people don't?
Yeah, that's a difficult question for me because those who I've studied, you know, I've interviewed over 2,000 people over the last 20 years. And the only ones I can be sure are government projects, part of their secret army of mind control people, if you will, is the ones that get voice to skull because the CIA uses just the, you know, two handfuls of scripts on them. And so even though it causes a lot of misperceptions and everything, I can read through all that. But I see how they introduce themselves and what they're trying to do. And so those are the only ones I can include in my study group. Those who just feel random pains, and then think they're TIs, that's not enough evidence for me. So I can't include them in my study.
So my question, okay, perhaps I didn't phrase it correctly. So in my case, I don't know if you've seen the picture, they left a giant microwave burn on my back. Okay, but that was in the midst of some very serious harassment. I mean, they pulled out all the stops on me. I'm just wondering, and I'm certain if they could have done V2K to me, they would have. However, after that,
okay. What happened? All right. I understand your question.
Somebody got very heavy-handed, and I have remote neural monitoring, so I do get constant pressure in my ears alternating right and left. Yeah, I'm wondering, what is the point of that? It's almost like I'm hooked up to AI and I can't be unhooked because my stalking has stopped. The harassment has stopped. But the neural monitoring, I guess that's what you'd call it, goes on.
Well, ask you a question. Why? How do you know the neural monitoring is going on if you have no feedback? You said the tortures.
Well, it corresponds to my every thought. It's yes or no, and for whatever reason, I don't remember. I do remember getting several darts in my eyes, that like pins, and I kept thinking, how did I keep getting something right there in that same spot in my eye, in the corner of my eye? At some point, I realized they could see what I could see. There were a multitude of things going on.
I believe you. I think that it's just a limitation of the technology, that they weren't able to cognitively model your auditory cortex. Otherwise, you would have the B2K. It's just, no weapon system is totally perfect. And in fact, that's why they have so many of TIs from every walk of life and every culture to try to fill their database with the probability models of efficacy of this weapon system for total control over all humans.
So that leads me to my next question. You know, if the ultimate outcome here, or the ultimate goal, is world domination, once that's achieved, then what? You know, I always think, okay, but then what are you going to do?
Yes. Oh, that question bothered me for so long. And here's the plan. They don't believe humans, as they grow with technological capability, can stop their inherent sinfulness, and that a single individual can wipe out the world now if they're not monitored. And so they're going to a system that would be a global hive mind, a peer-to-peer system with no secrecy, no judgments, and we work from that state. So they have a long-term plan, and I don't necessarily disagree with it, and a lot of people will hate me for saying that. I just disagree with the route they've taken and the methodology they've taken to torture so many innocent people, just so they can get the data that they need.
Is it true that there are people that are actually pressing these buttons? Because I find that rather difficult to believe.
No, it's happening so quickly in real time. No. It's all just a program, artificial intelligence. But they're chatterbots. You know what a chatterbot is. They don't work on everyone. Often people can realize this isn't a human. Can't remember anything I just said. It's just trying to incite me by questions, blah, blah, blah. And so with that, they have to have a human monitoring person that then can interject language that's believable as another being. But most of it is all programs. So, for example, if you hate stalking, it will keep creating that stalking for you.
As soon as you don't reprogram it.
Yeah. So let's say you can reprogram it. If you learn to separate in your mind the pain of a needle in your eye from as a false pain signal from a real pain signal that something's wrong with your body, they'll move on. They won't do it anymore. And that's the way the program works. It's why it's called Satan, silent assassination through adaptive neural networks. And it will only focus on what bothers you.
And so when nothing bothers you anymore, that's when it all stops.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
you're free. When nothing bothers you anymore, you're free.
Yeah. It doesn't bother me. So, I mean, is it true that you can reprogram it? Because I thought, well, if this is an AI, then it's just programmed.
Well,
I can reverse brainwash it.
Yeah, but remember, it's bidirectional. It's programming you, and you're programming it. So, you know, don't think you're in control.
No, I don't, but I think I'm helping steer it into a better direction, because that's really bothers me, is I know this technology actually has a lot of very phenomenally great applications.
Yes, and it that's actually, why they're going to release it in 2025. The public will get to know, not about that the government developed it, but that the simultaneous rediscoveries will show all the positive uses. We can help with Parkinson's. We can, you know, cure all sorts of mental illnesses and health. And that's the way it's going to be rolled out to the public. But now everyone gets a microchip and we don't have to have cash or keys. But it's still a grander strategy to enslave mankind. Don't forget that.
Okay,
no, I
Melissa.
Haven't. Is it Trump?
Thank you very much.
I'm done. Thank you.
Yeah. We have Michael from Phoenix.
Hi, Dr. Duncan. How you doing, sir?
Good. How are you, Michael?
Good, good. I'm a 15-year Air Force veteran. I've actually been the featured guest on the show before, long-term trauma-based mind control victim. Yeah. I've gotten every type of stalking, harassment, everything that anybody that's researched targeted individuals can get in my life. And
I'm sorry about that. I know how painful it is. Yes.
It's been a tough road.
How have you coped? Have you discovered any coping mechanisms?
Yeah. Actually, what I do is I document what's going on. I've built my own website, and I realized what was going on in April of 2017 is when the stalking and harassment went overt, and I started trying to figure out what was going on. I found Karen Melton Stewart on the internet, and what she was talking about was very similar to what was going on with me, and started understanding what was happening, and then I started documenting. I actually, when I was in the Air Force, I was a journalist, photo, video, and broadcast journalist, and I thought, you know, I've got these skills. I might as well start documenting this and bring this
what's
out to the public.
What's your last name? Okay, I've seen your site. Yeah.
Good, awesome. Yeah, we've talked, we've chatted on Facebook before, we've interacted before, and yeah. I tell people about you and your book all the time if they, you know, want to research things. So I think what you're doing is great. But I was just curious. So what about how long this has possibly been going on with me personally? I had parents. My dad worked for Lockheed Martin Skunk Works and Rocketdyne.
It's obvious why you got targeted, but go on.
my mom worked for the Federal Aviation Administration. I was born in Atlanta, California, around Edwards Air Force Base. All of my family were DOD contractors at Skunk Works or Department of Energy. And, when I realized what was going on and how this program works, I started going back in my timeline through life, and I could not find a specific time when this started, and I've heard a lot of people talk about that they were possibly sold into this program, or they were identified very young and put into this program at a young age. You know, what's the possibility that this started from the time that I was born?
Yes, okay. I understand your question. My question is, do you have V2K?
I have synthetic telepathy. I don't hear an audible voice.
When did they introduce themselves?
In as far as the synthetic telepathy, or as far as when they went over? The synthetic telepathy a couple years ago.
Okay. But here,
about 2 years.
unfortunately, you know, this started as far back as 1960s.
Okay.
It was brought over, you know, by the German scientists and stuff, but it really didn't go online in the 1960s. And then 1976, there was a huge bump. And then after 9/11, another huge bump of TIs. So is it possible the entire world is under this kind of mind control? Yes, it's possible.
Okay, guys, we have 2 minutes left. Can we get Dayden from India on?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Dr. Robert Duncan, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm just okay. I'm fighting back.
All right. That's all you can do.
Yeah. I have 3 questions for you, sir.
Make it one, Dayden, okay? Because we're trying to get some other people on.
Yeah.
Okay, at least 2 questions then. Yeah, so I have seen that most of the TIs live a single and jobless life. So is there hope and is there some tactics that TIs can apply to do away with single, loveless, and jobless life?
Okay, that's actually a good question. It depends on your country, obviously. And in my book, How to Tame a Demon, if your attacks are that bad that they leave you disabled, I say get the disabled income from your country and then try to form a unique business on your own. But no, that's a tough one because they want to make sure you're discredited.
Sorry.
Yeah, and discredited. And the symptoms that the doctor will give is a paranoid schizophrenia, and it doesn't.
Yeah, doctors.
If you don't have a 40% disability in India, you won't get anything from the government.
No, I know. And there have been so many people who have been fooled, from cops to shrinks.
Okay, guys, time is up. I'd like to thank Dr. Duncan and all of the guests who have called in. And I would like to say good night from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Thank you all.
Public Broadcasting Network, because you can handle the truth.